enough fit?
Yeah.
No.
I'd like to begin by acknowledging some folks who are with us here today. First and foremost, the Honorable George Amador, State Senator. Our Mayor of the City of Kingston, Steve Knoll. Members of the Ulster County Legislature for joining us, all the town supervisors with us today, and all the village mayors, as well as all the City of Kingston council members who have joined us here today. I also want to say a special thank you and welcome to the members of the Kingston DRI Committee. Thank you for being here. We are thrilled to be able to be joined by Governor Cuomo. It is always a pleasure to welcome Governor Cuomo to Ulster County, and I'd like to add a personal thank you to him for his support of the Strive Project. We were able to put a community college satellite campus right next to Kingston High School only because this governor made it possible.
All right. Woo!
Since day one, Governor Cuomo has focused on strategic, locally driven investments in the Hudson Valley and has accelerated growth across our region. Through his vision for an inclusive, bottom-up approach to economic development, Governor Cuomo is providing the tools and resources necessary for communities to succeed and to grow stronger. Here in Ulster County, the collaboration of business, civic, and academic leaders working along with the state has driven positive change and a serious uptick in our local economy. And this governor doesn't just talk about doing it, he gets things done. Yes. Woo! From cleaning up and protecting our environment, to investing in our infrastructure, to supporting businesses like Stockade Works Project right here in Kingston, this governor is delivering for Ulster County. Governor Cuomo has proven time and time again that government can get things done, and I am looking forward to what he has to say today. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the 56th governor of the state of New York, my friend, Governor Andrew Cuomo.
A lot of good memories. I'm around that creek with him.
with my boat ride once from Albany, and we came down, we came into Roundback Creek. So appreciate what you have. I mean, you have one of the most magnificent spots on the planet, right? You're on the Hudson River, all the history of the Hudson Valley. Everything you can imagine has been here. So it's my pleasure to be back. And it's my pleasure to see the progress that you've been making in Kingston, because things are going in the right direction and the arrows are pointed in the right direction. And you should all be proud. Kingston has had economic challenges, like a lot of upstate New York. No fault of Kingston, no fault of upstate New York. It was, if anything, we were a victim of the transfer from the manufacturing economy. You know, New York was all about manufacturing. That's what we were, Hudson River, Erie Canal. We were there first, and we invested in manufacturing. And that economy turned like they changed the channel on a TV years ago. And that manufacturing base moved out of New York, moved out of this country. And then upstate New York had to figure out what to do for the second economy. What was the next act, you know? Overnight, you lose 7,000 IBM jobs in the Kingston area. Where do you get another 7,000 jobs? Rochester was Kodak and Bausch and Lomb. And overnight, they were gone. Buffalo was a steel town. That's what they did. That's what everybody did. What your father did, that's what the family did. And then steel moves overseas. This is a story for us upstate New York. State government, frankly, compounded the problem. Why? Because while that was going on, while that transition was going on, the state wasn't being helpful. If anything, was being hurtful. We kept raising taxes, raising taxes, raising taxes. Businesses are mobile. At one point, they pick up their laptops and they leave. So we had to get our state's fiscal house in order, which we did. We cut spending way down. We now have the lowest spending increases in state government year to year in the history of the state of New York, believe it or not. We kept it down to below 2%. You keep spending down, then you can cut taxes. And we cut taxes. Middle class tax rate up to $300,000 is the lowest tax rate since 1947. Lowest corporate tax rate since 1968. So now we're more business friendly. We're very aggressive in going out and soliciting business and bringing them back. Our head of economic development today, Howard Zimsky's in Texas, trying to wine and dine and seduce a company from Texas to come back. I love getting companies from Texas, I'll tell you this. Because my walk through. And state government, and the senator makes this point often in Albany, the state government was not focused enough on the problems of upstate New York. They were downstate focused. Why? Because it's human nature, that's where they come from. Most of the legislators are from the New York City area. So you want to do for your district, and most of them are from New York City. We changed that philosophy. We said we're going to do what we need to do in New York City, and I'm proud of that. But upstate New York is the area that really needs the help. And the role of government is to provide the assistance to the places that need it. And I'm proud to be able to stand before you today and say, my administration has invested more money in upstate New York than any administration in the history of the state. We started building tourism, which is a great economic engine. We now have 239 million tourists came last year, highest number of tourists in the history of the state of New York. And tourists bring tourist dollars. We've had a 13% increase in tourism in the Hudson Valley. Tourism is now a $1.8 billion industry. And then we built tourism-related industries like wineries and cideries and breweries, and it's created a whole new economy. We have wine trails, we have a beer trails, et cetera. So it's been going very, very well. We also realized that Albany can't sit there and figure out from Albany what works as a business plan for Kingston, or what works as a business plan for Buffalo. So we said, look, we have 10 different regions in the state, call them regional economic development councils. Each region, you come up with your own plan, and we'll invest in your plan. And that's what we've done. And it's gone extraordinarily well in the Hudson Valley. Jobs are up, unemployment is down, we have more to do, but we've made great progress. And then we said, we have the states working, and the regions are working, you also need the local community to work. And you need to come up with a plan that is really from the bottom up. So we said, we're gonna have a competition. And we're gonna ask communities all across the state, what is your vision for revitalizing the downtown area? And we would award the 10 best programs in the state 10 million each, okay? That was the plan. You came up with a great downtown revitalization. High marks from everyone using the Stockade District with the history, the restaurants and the cafes that are already growing, commercial mixed-use development, bringing residential into the downtown area. It was a brilliant, brilliant plan. But something happened. It didn't go exactly according to the way we forecasted. We thought we're going to have 10 winners, $10 million each. We thought maybe we'd have 15 applications, 20 applications, over 100 applications for 10 spots, okay? And these are all smart plans because we've been working at this for a while now. We've been doing the regional plan, we've been focused on economic development. So we have over 100 really, really smart plans. So we modified the program a little bit, and we said first place winners are going to get $10 million each. We'll have second place winners that get $8 million. Third place gets $6 million. Fourth place gets a set of steak knives. So you really don't want to be fourth. Look, I know everybody wants to be first, and that's great, that competitive instinct, but second place, $8 million is still a lot of money, and you can do a lot of work. Third place, $6 million is still a lot of money, and you can do a lot of work. And remember the number of competitors we had here from all across the state that worked very hard. So, with that context, I am pleased to inform you today that you are a first place winner. Congratulations. Use it well.
one, I'm actually going to lose $1 million because of the heat in here. So I'm, again, so excited to be able to welcome Governor Cuomo to Kingston, and to be able to have all of us today to talk about our plan to revitalize our Stockade district and to be able to lift up our city. As the governor mentioned, we have worked, had some tough times over the years. He describes exactly what happened in Kingston when we lost our manufacturing hubs in the 80s and 90s. And today, you look around Kingston and you see some rebirth because we had some really committed and dedicated residents who said, you know what, Kingston, I see potential. I see a light at the end of your tunnel. But, you know, what we also realized, though, is in order for this to be successful, we needed to have a revitalized downtown. And for the governor to come out with this initiative last year, it aligned exactly with what we were trying to do. And so, again, I applaud you and your administration for recognizing for that our communities and for Kingston to be successful, we need our downtowns to have residential, commercial, sustainable, resilient, vibrant business district, and we have that, that will lift up our entire city because we have struggles. There's no question, we have a lot of work to do. But with your assistance and with my partner, County Executive Mike Hine, with me literally every step of the way, I couldn't be more proud of the work that we have done together on this initiative and with his team and my Office of Economic and Community Development working with me and with us to be able to talk more loudly about what our vision was. And really, from this day forward, we have a lot of work to do. I know it's not going to be easy, but I know that I can count on each and every one of you in this room to move this forward and to be able to help move our city into a place that it's never been. This literally is going to be transformative for our community. And so, Governor, thank you.
Thank you. That's right. I just celebrated my first year.
Listen, I have more passion. David, turn around. You're with him.
Hey, Frank, how you doing?
How you doing?
It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
They're not the nice people.
They're not nice.
Take care, see you. Bye.
I just wanted to mention it to you because it's a big component.
Carpenter at the Broadmoor.
It feels a lot nicer out here, boy. You're not missing anything. That was hot. Got some of that.